A lot was covered and said about the fourth Democratic debate this week, and we're breaking down the four claims that struck us as questionable and worth taking a look into. So let's dive right in.
We are in Ohio tonight because it's one of the most critical battleground states. Ohio has backed all but two.
People of Hong Kong rise up for democracy and don't get a peep of support from the president.
So is this accurate? Well, thousands of people in Hong Kong have been participating in demonstrations against the Chinese government for months now, since June to be exact. This movement began to protest an extradition bill which would have allowed China to extradite people suspected of a crime and to be tried under China's judicial system, but evolved into a broader movement for Hong Kong's autonomy from China. So the big question here, has Trump shown his support for the democratic process being exercised in Hong Kong or not? Well, in August, President Trump was asked if he was concerned about the fact that the Chinese army appeared to be preparing to interfere with the demonstrators, to which he said,
"And I don't know what China's attitude is. Somebody said that at some point they're going to want to stop that. But that's between Hong Kong and that's between China, because Hong Kong is a part of China. They'll have to deal with that themselves."
But then in September, while speaking at a United Nations summit, he said this while addressing the Chinese government.
"The world fully expects that the Chinese government will honor its binding treaty made with the British and registered with the United Nations, in which China commits to protect Hong Kong's freedom, legal system, and democratic ways of life."
So saying that President Trump hasn't said a peep isn't completely accurate, but it's up to your interpretation as to whether or not he issued support for the demonstrators. The second claim of the debate that we're taking a look into was a remark made by Julian Castro.
"Ohio, Michigan, and Pennsylvania actually, in the latest jobs data, have lost jobs, not gained them."
Okay, well, according to the most recent data by the Bureau of Labor Statistics, all three states saw an increase in the number of jobs in August. So how did Castro come to this analysis? His campaign confirmed with PolitiFact that they based their findings by comparing March and July figures, which show that employment did in fact drop in all three states. But I'm sure you're wondering why the figures from August weren't used, even though they are readily available stats. This is because the figures have not been made official and are expected to be revised, which is common when analyzing employment figures. But what is uncommon is to not even acknowledge the most recent stats, even if they may alter. So stay tuned on how the figures end up turning out once they are made official. Another stat that was used Tuesday night was by Elizabeth Warren addressing national support for Roe versus Wade.
"And we now have support across this country. 3 out of 4 Americans believe in the rule of Roe versus Wade. When you've got 3 out of 4 Americans supporting it, we should be able to get that passed through Congress."
You've probably heard this stat before, because it came from an NPR Maris poll that found that 77% of Americans want to uphold Roe versus Wade, while 13% said it should be overturned. So do these figures compare to other polls taken? A Gallup poll, also from June, found that 60% of Americans do not want the Supreme Court to overturn Roe versus Wade. And another poll taken in August by the Pew Research Center found that 70% of people support the Supreme Court ruling. So while the stats vary, the statement is pretty accurate. The last claim we wanted to verify was a statement made by Kamala Harris.
"The leading cause of death of young black men in America is gun violence, more than the top other 6 reasons totaled."
Okay, looking at figures tracked by Amnesty International, young black men make up a disproportionately large number of those killed by gun violence in the United States. And from 2014 to 2015, homicide was the leading cause of death for young black men ages 15 to 24, roughly 94% of which were the result of gun violence, according to the Centers for Disease Prevention and Control. Harris's claim that gun violence alone has killed more black men in this age bracket than the next 6 top causes of death combined is accurate for that time frame. And in 2016, homicide was once again the leading cause of death for black men in the age brackets of 1 to 19 and 20 to 44. However, the CDC has not released a detailed breakdown of black male deaths related to gun violence since 2015. So at this time, we can't confirm or reject this claim. So as with any polarizing issue, always to be sure to check your facts and look up the stats yourself. All the claims we just reviewed weren't necessarily false, but they also don't portray the whole picture. If you want to learn more about Check Your Fact, follow us on Facebook and subscribe so you can stay up to date on our latest fact checks.